The Islamic State has a plan to conquer Rome. Yes, it sounds crazy, but ISIS believes the conquest of Rome is central to its mission and necessary to fulfill what Islam teaches was the prophecy of Muhammad and to prepare the return of the Muslim Messiah, the Mahdi. Robert Spencer is the author of The Complete Infidel's Guide to ISIS.
ISIS thinks that Rome is one of its primary goals and that it is in its timetable. It has a timetable wherein, in the next 10 years, by the year 2025, it hopes to bring about Armageddon, the final struggle between good and evil, or between the Muslims and the non-Muslims. And that one of the chief stepping stones to that Armageddon battle is the conquest of Rome, which they think they're going to be able to do within the next 5 years, that is by 2020.
Muslim scholars say Muhammad prophesied that the two great Roman cities would be conquered, Constantinople and Rome. Constantinople today is Istanbul, a Muslim city. Rome remains to be conquered.
Once Rome is conquered in this view, within the next 5 years, and then Israel will follow shortly after. They also believe that during this time period, they're going to conquer Saudi Arabia and Iran.
Now, before you laugh, consider that phase one of the Islamic State's plan to take Rome may already be underway, flooding Europe with ISIS fighters under the cover of the refugee crisis.
They're not talking about doing it by conventional armies. They're talking about doing it by overwhelming these lands with sympathizers from within and an influx of other people from outside.
The Islamic State reveals part of its plan in its publication, Black Flags from Rome. It will use sleeper cells and expects to get help from Muslims serving in European armies and from non-Muslim sympathizers. It also wants to fire missiles into Italy that it has captured on the battlefield. This is a threat that is hard to be concerned about for Italian and foreign policy expert Emmanuel Ottolenghi.
The concern should be commensurate to the reality of the threat. The Islamic State does not pose that kind of a threat today.
He says Europe faces more pressing problems because of ISIS.
I think that the much larger threat that we are concerned with in Europe is with the lone wolf terrorist who plots a terror outrage against a school, against a supermarket, against a shopping mall, against an airport.
And it is hard to see how ISIS could conquer a city of 3 million people in a nation of 60 million people. But it is not hard to see ISIS attempting it. The conquest of Rome has been a primary goal since the beginning of the Islamic State.
They think that the conquest of Rome will be the complete sign of Islam's superiority over Christianity and defeat of Christianity.
They also see the fall of Rome on an eschatological timeline that will culminate in a battle near Dabiq, Syria, their version of Armageddon.
And they think that once this battle takes place at Dabiq, this final battle, which they see coming in by 10 years from now, in 2025, that the Muslims will battle the non-Muslims in this town in northern Syria, and then Jesus, the Muslim prophet, and the Mahdi will return to the earth, and they will together conquer and Islamize the world.
If their plan for Rome succeeds, ISIS says it will throw homosexuals from the top of the Leaning Tower of Pisa. But the chief target is Vatican City in Rome. And the main event, as they see it, will be the beheading of the Pope in St. Peter's Square, broadcast and live-streamed to an international audience.
There was a Polish convert to Islam recently who has joined the Islamic State, and he said, once we take Rome, we're going to carry out mass beheadings in St. Peter's Square. And so this is the plan, to convert St. Peter's Square into a huge site of executions of people considered to be the enemies of Allah, chief among them the Pope, in order to cow and frighten the rest of the world into submitting to their rule.
It's a plan that for now has little chance of success. But in his new book, The ISIS Apocalypse, author and expert William McCant says, ISIS has recently taken a longer-term view of the conquest of Rome and the return of the Mahdi, and is willing to wait in order to build up its forces. ISIS is already next door to Italy in North Africa. More importantly, Islamic State fighters are almost certainly already inside the country, some posing as refugees, going about their lives, waiting for the day when the battle for Rome begins. Dale Hurd, CBN News, Rome.